Hi, Christian. It was great talking with you. I wanted to send you this quick website audit, as promised, to show you where your company is ranking currently and what your competitors are doing to claim the top spots on Google. So in this video, I'm going to go over a few easy ways to beat your competition online. Now, I know that most business owners are extremely busy and they don't have the time to handle all of the marketing needs of their business. So I started making these videos with just some helpful tips and suggestions. So I hope this is helpful to you. If you have any questions or if you'd like to discuss any of this further, I'd love to hop on a call with you and talk. But either way, this video is 100% yours to keep. So the three things we're going to go over today are content, backlinks, and citations. Content is anything on the homepage of your site that Google can read. So all the text on the front page, all the text within your images, and whatever your images are saved as. Now, to be considered authority in Google's eyes, you're going to want to have at least 1,500 to 2,000 words on your homepage, and you're going to want it to be stuffed with content that has to do with buyer intent. So for you specifically, you'd be looking at things like Painter San Antonio, Kitchen Remodel San Antonio, other keyword phrases along those lines. That way, when anyone types those searches into Google, your website will pop right up. Now, looking at your website, I really like how you put the testimonials right here. Those are always a huge plus to have. And I like how you put your pictures to display all of your work down here. And something I'd recommend is maybe adding any awards or certifications that you have to this homepage, and then even linking it to a social media page. So I know a lot of people are really big on Instagram and looking at different like before and after photos of different remodel jobs. So that's just something to think about. Always a great way to enhance your visitors' experience to your site. So looking at the rest of your website, I really like how you showcase your work in the gallery. So let me go up here to gallery. So one suggestion that I have for you is to go ahead and split up, make a service menu item here, and then go ahead and split up different service pages for each of the services that you offer. That really helps each service to rank in the Google searches. So let's say somebody was looking specifically for a kitchen remodel. If you have kitchen remodel under your services, they could click on kitchen remodel, go to that page, and then go ahead and get, you know, a bigger description of what you guys do, maybe some before and afters on the page, just showcasing your work more. It's just really great to describe each service in detail using keywords throughout the description. That way, when people search for that on Google, your website will pop up for that. If you do end up doing that where you split up your service pages, you're gonna wanna strive for 500 words. That's typically a good number as far as content goes. And then, you know, of course you want keywords throughout that 500 words. So a rule of thumb I like to use is one keyword phrase for every 100 words about. So if you were to do 500 words on a service page, you could have about five keywords in there. Anywhere from 3 to 5 would be good. And then you want to just kind of have it organically throughout the paragraph. So definitely don't want to just shove the words in or the keyword phrases in. Google's smart, and they can sense when you're trying to keyword stuff, is what they call it. So overall, the main thing that I would tell you for your homepage is that you're going to want to add more content to it. So it looks like you have about 150 words here whenever I did my word counter on this. And you're going to want to have at least 1,500 to 2,000, like I mentioned earlier. So you'll want to have more relevant keyword-rich content and then kind of follow that same principle that I did with, that I told you about with the service pages. So if you have 1,500 words, you'll want to do 10 to 15 keyword phrases throughout the front page here, the home page. So overall, I really like your site, and I think just with a few tweaks, it could rank much higher on Google. The next thing I want to go over with you is backlinks. So the thing with Google is it can kind of be like a popularity contest because they judge you by how many websites are pointing back at you. Now, very important to remember, not all backlinks are created equal. So what that means is you're going to gain a lot more influence from a backlink that is related to your industry specifically. So, for example, a reputable home improvement blog that mentions your company would be a good one for you, or a popular website that features various types of home services or remodels, that would also be really good. Something that has to do with the services you offer is going to give you a lot more influence. You're gonna get a lot more from that type of backlink versus a backlink from, let's say, your local Domino's Pizza or Macy's department store, for example. So a tool I use to measure backlinks is called ARIFS. So I went ahead and put your website into ARIFS here. It looks like you have two backlinks and you have those backlinks from one website. So one referring domain and a zero for your organic traffic. So what that tells me is that you're not getting any website visits. So there's no traffic coming into your website and you're losing out on a lot of potential clients that way. Now, compared to your top competitor in San Antonio, Legacy Bath & Kitchen, which I'm sure you've heard of, they have backlinks. Here they are right here. They have backlinks that are higher quality, and therefore they have a lot more power and tons of organic traffic coming in. So it looks like they had 392 website visits in the past 30 days. So a strategy we tell our clients to use to get that same kind of influence and power as their competitors is to go in and get the same backlinks as they have and then continue to keep adding more and more, so you'll end up surpassing them while gaining more power to your site and a lot more organic traffic and new customers. And the last thing I want to talk to you about today is citations. Citations are very important because if someone wants a service now, they're going to most likely go to Google, type it in. So let's just type in, yep, here you go, kitchen remodel, San Antonio. So here are your competitors in the local map pack. And a lot of people, when they type this in, they think of these three businesses as the most reputable. They have ratings, they have reviews, and they see them as the best potentially because they pop up here at the top. So it makes sense that they would think that, but they're not necessarily the best companies for remodeling. It's just that they have more citations. So citations are anywhere on the internet where your name, your phone number, and your address are listed in different directories such as Yelp, Facebook, and Yellow Pages, and others, just to name a few. So again, what we tell our clients is the same type of strategy that we use with backlinks. You go in and whatever directories your competition is being listed in, you list yourself in those exact same directories, and then you add on a space cushion of, let's say, 20 to 30% more directories than your competition. Over time, what's gonna happen is you're gonna end up infiltrating this Google My Business local map pack. You'll be ranking at the top, and by the time your competitors realize it, they're not gonna be able to catch up because you'll just keep adding on more backlinks, more citations, and taking on all of that new business. So here is my website, Lobo Leads, and here's my phone number, and I'll include all of that contact info in the email as well. But Christian, in closing, one last time, I just wanted to thank you for taking the time to watch my video and talk with me, and I really appreciate it, and I definitely hope to hear back from you soon. Thanks.